Wesley finally got himself some axolotls. We got three of them. They weren't cheap, but still cheaper than you normally get them.
Oh. And my buddy Mark.
Seller 172, bag 28. It is a bag of the Bacopa money wart. Started at $3 on a little bag of plant. $3. Anyone do three? Three looking for four.
This thing is too cool. This is a albino Lucy GHB. It's really neat.
Seriously, like a little water dragon.
Down he goes.
It's got this sparkle all over him too, which is really neat. And those eyes.
Crazy. And a regular GHB, Lucy. Black eye is so cool. Things are neat.
You can definitely see why people get into these though, for sure. Tail's kind of goofy, but we like goofy.
When this guy had fell into the dirty sink, it was a mission getting him out. Here's the melanistic one. He's doing good. I hope. They have already been eating tetracolor tropical granules. Next day in the light. How cool are these things? With the sparkle on it. I need to get a little cave for him to kind of rest in. A little tadpole. Hello, fella. Melanistic one. This guy done found a spot. Alright, so we finally got Wesley some axolotls here. And I have never kept these before. I have kept a lot of things in nature now. These are filterless setups. These tanks have been up for like maybe 2 days. This is sand dirt that I got from my yard. I do got well water, so the water is sort of naturally, biologically fresher than, say, city water. So I think I'm able to get away with that because of this. Or get away with this because of that. Anyways, they're doing good. I got them some caves. Got them some shrimp and Daphnia going with them. Not sure how that'll work. I think I'm going to put them all three into their living situation because they're going to end up living together anyways. Wish me luck on all this because those things aren't cheap. And eventually I'll get them some worms too. I wanted to get some plants, but I do worry about the snails, and I heard they can choke on things, so I don't know. I don't want them to choke on snails. Let me know what you guys think. Wow, look at this sparkle on that thing. Caves and crustaceans have been added. Get them some worms. This is probably a better way to catch them than that. Oh, I don't know. They're faster than I thought. I thought they were slow. They're tadpole fast. Come on, buddy. Come on in here. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
They're good.
No, we may need a net. So I used the net to catch them and then got them in the container. That way the net doesn't tear them up. It's kind of a coarse net. Ooh, I think the shrimp like the axolotl. I think they're going to be friends. Look at them. They're having a meeting. Look, they're all grouped up in front of them. That's so crazy. Is that crazy, Wesley?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, easy. All right, all three have been added. I've also got some Daphnia in here with them.
Okay, he's maybe eating a shrimp. And this way, if I do put granules in there, the shrimp will at least eat them if they don't eat them. But catching them really made me feel better about how these creatures really react. Now, they are fairly quick. They look like they're slow as they walk around, but when it comes to it, they can go. And this here will be their permanent residence. This is a 40-gallon breeder. They were in a 20-gallon high. We do have a cave in here. This has just got a bunch of sand on it. And I do have Chattanooga Ed, hopefully, will be hooking me up with some caves as well. Check this cave out. This is cool. It's kind of like buried down and into the ground. It's like a little underground bunker for them. I think that'll be neat. So really, I just need to get water in here and let it season up for a little while. With the rain finally cool enough to finally get these going in here. I didn't want to open up the door with as hot as it's been. Finally get these inler tanks going. Woo woo. Found the biggest female blue dream ever. She's about as big as them mollies. It's crazy. All right, you got the water going in the permanent axolotl tank. Hopefully get some caves from Chattanooga Ed. She's creative. But we got that cave down there in the meantime. Good old plate method to keep the sand from just kicking up everywhere. See how clear that is as it goes in? Clean, clear, crispy. Did go ahead and get some pogo stem and stellata. I got this out of the pond since there's not a lot of snails in the ponds. In the pond. So far doing good. I do worry if they're eating. They've eaten some, but that's food from the day. That's food from the day. Hope they find it. If not, I hope the shrimp are. And I'm definitely minus a lot more shrimp, so I think they've been eating those. The Daphnia, he gotta look like he's got a little belly on him. You go get him some worms from somewhere. Alright, there we have it. It's got water. Might as well top off everything else. Okay, I had to turn the light on. Because, I mean, I think I like sunlight. So far, they're doing great. No filter. No, the internet's gonna hate me for this whole no filter bit with these, but no, I debunk a lot that the internet says. So go ahead. I've been naturing this nature for quite some time, y'all. Not doing anything different though. Update on the bathtub shiner. Yes, this is in my master bathroom. Now, would your girlfriend let you do this? I must be doing something right. But anyways, they're all doing healthy in here. This is green water, doing quick water change on them. And I am working my way on getting these out so she can get her bathtub back, but it's going to take a little cleaning. Can't tell I'm a hardcore fish keeper. And just like all the Melinda Williams Creek rainbow fish babies. Really hard to see in here, but I've got a bunch from the Sentiensis. There's a few of them. After selling those. So that's a good thing is if I do get the new rainbow fish and then I do end up selling them, even if they're not as strange as I want, they'll still get back up either way. Now, the Coldwater Creek, I don't know if I'll get back up with them because there's a rope fish in there. But I do plan on moving these Synergos and the Cato Rivers, which these I am keeping. And hopefully I'll get some babies out of those. There's at least got to be 30, 50 of these little babies throughout the tank.
Here's a little sneak peek of what my neighbor's been up to. He's been building his own fish room as well. There he is, Connor.
Trying to become like Lucas, fish guru.
And check this out. It's got a bunch of that yard rock, that yard sand. Got the plants going. And he's doing this with ambient light. As you can see, no filters. And lots of room to expand.
Oh yeah. Plenty of room for right more tanks. Plenty of right room.
And every command center's got to start somewhere.
That's right.
I like how he's got the rocks spread out here and there. And you can look all the way down it.
Thinking about wanting to come out here and look at them, so I was like, shit, I guess I can. Come out here and turn that light on, and they look like they was all sleeping.
Like,
oh, yeah.
Down. Is that just kind of like it's. This is cool. Found my first praying mantis in the fish room. These guys are so fun to watch. So it's almost been a week now. As you can see, I grabbed some plants, some pogo stemming from the pond. It was the one with the least snails. I was doing research. They can't eat snails, so I don't think that's a big issue. These guys are hunting some shrimp. Really, really fun to watch. I've got a bunch of Daphne in there, too. I've been feeding them. I need to get them some better warm source. I still haven't gotten to that. But hopefully I'll figure it out, make a decision. It's hard to find worms in my yard being all sand, but I don't know, I could try harder. But anyways, really fun to see these guys in the plants. They really love to hang out in the plants, so they should be ready for their new home soon. I got the water in it, as you guys saw. But I am loving these guys, absolutely loving them. No, they were for Wesley, but they're so adorable. And on their gills, they have like different colors. See, this one's even got like a gold speckle to it. Oh, oh, there it goes. And they have been eating the tetracolor tropical granules. I'll let them float at the top since they hang up towards the top a lot. It's fairly easy to feed them. Yeah, your belly looks pretty full. Not looking too hungry, guy. I love the melanistic back here. Where'd it go? He moved. Oh no, he's hiding right in front of me. See how it has the orange in the gills there? Really neat. It's like a fluorescent orange too. And his green eyes. How cute is that face? And they always look like they're smiling. Always smiling. And I didn't realize how much they actually swim. I thought they were really slow and derpy, but they're all over the place. They're all over the place. And these guppies, I'm about to put them into the barn too. Even though some of them look like they're about to pop, I may go ahead and let them pop in here. Then take them out and raise their babies in here. Because I don't have a whole lot in the pipeline for filling the quarantine up with. I may just focus on growing these plants out, not having to throw food in there. We'll see. As you can see here, it's getting late, but thank you all so much for watching, so much for the support. Really appreciate you all, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Take care. I got the Millennium Orange Albino Rainbows moved. Loving them in their new tank.